we propose an inverse waterfall chart where each ESG aspect is a separate selection that you do as a company. And each aspect has the weight that you assign this bar. So that at the end of the day, to the left of the, to the right of the chart, you see an orange bar with your cumulated ESG performance. So what we are recommending not to do, we advise against an ABC rating that the rating agencies use, because we believe this is a lot less easy to understand than a scale from 0 to 100% to maybe 200%. How do we get to this chart? It all starts with your unweighted ESG performance that can be represented in a bar chart. What you see here is that actual client where we implemented an ESG performance method. And this client has selected carbon, innovation, gender, materials, and water as their important aspects in their ESG strategy. And for each of those aspects, we have used these functions that I showed you before and assessed how well they did in that year, in the year 2020, last year. So what you see here, they completely outperformed their carbon target. They were at 200% target achievement. On the innovation side, they just matched their target. So they have a value of 100%. Gender is an outperformance. Was, by the way, two metrics that flew into gender. Materials, they wanted to use biodegradable materials, was an underperformance in that year. And water was an outperformance. They wanted to use less water. So the result of that, if you look at all these bars, the average of those bars is the company overall ESG performance. And it can be calculated quite easily because these are all percentage values. And the result, again, is a percentage value. So it's really just a simple average of the first five bars. Now, this we recommend to turn into the waterfall chart, because the waterfall chart can accommodate different weightings. This company has chosen to weight everything the same. So the result, the orange bar, is the same because it's the same weighting. It's just another representation that is more intuitive to understand, especially if there are weightings applied, because you cannot see the weightings on the left side, but on the right side, if carbon would have a higher weight, maybe double the weight than the others, it would now be higher. And because carbon was an outperformance, the orange bar would be higher too. What we have here on the left side is the chart that we showed you before, where everything is scaled from 0% to 200%. And the only thing we have to do to convert that into a compensation is by changing the scale on the vertical axis. It doesn't go from 0% to 200%. It goes from 0x bonus to 1x bonus to 2x bonus, target bonus. So the only thing we have to do is really change the scale to make that easier to understand, and 144% ESG achievement, which was the result for this company on the left side, turns into 1.44 times target compensation. Looking at this consolidated ESG performance representation makes ESG compensation really easy. We recommend it because people without financial background can understand it, no matter what metrics you use. Even if they have no idea about the HR side or the production side, they still understand what a 150% achievement of a certain metric is. It actually has built-in caps, targets, and floors, and that's important for compensation. In compensation, you always want to have a floor and a cap. Uncapped compensation is being frowned upon. And finally, it can be used for internal management and leadership, as well as communicating to external parties. This is also really good. It's not confidential. It doesn't reveal your targets. It just reveals how you assess the performance of your targets, and you can decide yourself how transparent you want to be about your targets.